everybody. Welcome back to Learn with Parqa. I'm Chanel.
And I'm Kelli.
And we're here back in your LinkedIn feed to bring you Learn with Parqa, which is really all around marketing insights for the staffing and recruiting industry specifically. We have a fun topic for you this week, and we wanted to kind of take a moment to pause and reflect on a successful year of 2021 and some of the key trends and highlights that we saw throughout this entire year. Can you believe we're already in December? Holy smokes.
It's amazing.
How did we get here? So we're going to start with a personal update from both of us. Mine being that I'm actually pregnant with my first kid on the way, so that's exciting. We're expecting our son in January, so that's my biggest update, you know, reviewing or looking back on the year of 2021.
For sure. And my update is that I have a 20-month-old, so if you've been tracking with my various LinkedIn posts, I had my first, also a boy, right before the pandemic hit, March 18th. So if you're curious, how long has this thing been around? About 20 months. And we're in a really nice phase of throwing food sometimes, screaming, also cute and cuddly. So hopefully you feel the same in your post-pandemic blues or wonder.
Yes.
Like, okay, we're getting used to the new normal. We're kind of getting to our groove. So
yes.
There you have it. There's the personal update.
Yes. Okay. What you're here for, I suppose, is the actual industry-related trends and insights. So Kelli, start us off.
So the first one is all around technology. Shocker, right? I mean, there's been so many exciting things happening in our industry. Even just as an example, the HR tech space has experienced unprecedented venture capital backing. $7.5 billion this year. That is more than double 2019 and 2020 combined. To make it a little bit more near and dear and personal to our industry, Sense just received $50 million in additional funding. And so it is rapidly accelerating, and there are so many implications for what that can mean for your business.
Mm-hmm. And we've actually, you want to speak about the hiring?
Yes. So it's one of those things where we are acclimating with the growth, just like you guys are as well. And so we have focused on a few key hires this year. You've probably seen Toby, you've met Julie, you know, individuals who come from other industries that tend to be a little bit faster paced when it comes to marketing and technology than the staffing industry. And so they've joined our team to help accelerate our clients' adoption of what this means, you know, how you can solve business challenges through technology and through marketing. So we're really excited about that. Feel free to check out their LinkedIn profiles.
Yeah. Secondly, the candidate experience. I think that was the most spoken phrase inside the four walls at Parqa this year. And that's really because, yes, there's a candidate shortage, right? We saw that trend of the great resignation happen throughout 2021 of people leaving their current places of work in droves because they knew that they had the power to go and find that next career opportunity where they were known and seen and valued and their hard work was recognized and they could get that pay bump or promotion, right? So the candidate is very much in the driver's seat.
Mm-hmm.
So while that candidate shortage is happening and it's really, you know, that war on talent is very, very fierce and competitive right now, we actually believe that there's a shortage of the right messaging and content to reach the candidate and to resonate with that candidate and bring them in to the fold of your company and to get them excited about your company. So that messaging is so important, right? If they just feel like they're being communicated in a templated manner and they're getting auto emails and it sounds spammy and, you know, that's not the experience you want to offer. We always, you know, we've been joking lately about how you can order a pizza these days and know exactly what the status is of that pizza from the moment it like goes into production to when it goes in the oven to when it's on its way to your door. Like, why is it that you get such a great experience and visibility into ordering a pizza, but not when it comes to a career change, which has the, you know, ability to affect the trajectory of the rest of your life. So just a huge disconnect right now in that overall candidate experience and a huge, even more so, opportunity to build a candidate experience that resonates with candidates, that attracts them, and ultimately allows you to grow your business with a talent pool present.
Mm-hmm. And as this technology accelerates, more and more staffing firms that you're competing with will adopt it.
Mm-hmm.
But most of those will say, okay, there's some templated birthday anniversary messages I can do. Yeah. Awesome, you know, NPS score, are you happy? Can you refer people? And there's not a lot of give back. And so that's also tied into thinking about your ideal customer profile and who they are and what matters to them and how you can add value to them. So one technology that's doing a good job of helping to streamline that process, make it a little bit more of a pizza where's my box efficiency, is staffing engine. And you know, if you think about your candidate, you send in an application on a Friday. The recruiter, you know, when it hits their inbox, it's Friday afternoon, they're getting caught up on things. Then they're on the weekend, then Monday hits, they're doing their stand-up huddle, they're doing their coffee break, they go and they grab, you know, go through more of their emails. It might be Monday afternoon or Tuesday before you as a recruiter even get your resume reviewed, if you're one of 100, right? And so tools like Staffing Engine say, all right, there can be a middle step where we can start vetting the process, and you can get an automated, message that says, let's learn a little bit more about you. You know, like, what are your skills? And there are things that the recruiter would need to ask and know in that first conversation, but there are also things that you want to provide so that you can get further down the pipeline, essentially, and get closer to being the one that gets that role that you want. And so it is just exciting to see how this technology is marrying the content side and the brain power, even just like on our team, to say, okay, what do those messages need to be to resonate with the candidate right now?
Yeah, and to give them that on-demand experience where they feel seen, known, heard, and that they're actually moving through this process, and that there's a two-way, you know, piece of communication there. So, a lot happened this year looking back. A lot more than we were able to cover in today's short video, but we would love to hear what you saw in your business this year. What were some of those key trends and highlights and insights that you saw? And even more so, looking forward to 2022, how do you want to grow? Who do you want to be in the marketplace?
Right?
What do you want to prioritize? How do you want to grow your business? Those are the types of conversations that really get us energized here at Parqa. So we'd love to hear from you. Reach out to us personally on LinkedIn or visit parkamarketing.com to learn more, and we will see you guys next time.